made dosa and sambar from scratch. Okay, so I took 1/4 cup of urad dal, 1 cup of rice and 1 teaspoon of methi dana, wash it really well and then blend it. It should become a paste like this. And then just leave it in a warm place overnight to ferment. The next morning I added some water and salt to it to get it to the consistency that typically your store-bought dosa batter is. For the sambar, I boiled 1/2 cup arhar dal with 1.5 cup of water for 10 minutes. And now I'm doing like a shortcut baby method of making sambar because I'm not very confident. So I'm boiling the sambar powder with water because I'm really scared of burning it. Add in about a tablespoon of imli paste, or you can increase it or decrease it as per your taste. Let it come to a boil and then just add this to your dal. So this is my shortcut method. I'm grabbing some fresh kadi patta for the tadka. Got desi ghee in a tadka pan, some mustard seeds or rye. Add in 1 sabut lal mirch and the kadi patta, and that's it, your tadka is ready. Pour out your sambar into a bowl, add the tadka, and tada! Quick no veggie sambar is ready in a jiffy. Now the dosa. I've got my tawa on medium heat, some ghee on it, and now just going to put 1 ladle of the batter in and spread it into a dosa. At this point it should be on low heat. And let me just warn you that usually whether it's the dosa or a pancake, the first one almost always goes bad. So don't stress too much. And the idea is to just be really, really patient with it. Let it be on slow for a long time till you see some color changing on the top. Try to loosen the edges, add some more ghee if it looks like it's drying up or not coming off easily. So as expected, it is sticking a bit. Because dosas are really all about temperature control, and in the first one you usually end up with some trouble, so don't worry, just be very gentle, get this off and we'll do a fresh one. So I've got my pan on low heat now, 1 more ladle, just spread it nice and thin, and as soon as you do, add some ghee or coconut oil or regular oil, whatever you prefer. Just make sure you put it all around the edge. And just on a very low flame, let it crispen up for quite some time till you see the color changing on top. So now we can really see the color turning into a dark brown. Don't worry, this has not burnt yet. Now very gently, let's just try to lift the edges. Look at how perfect that's turned out. It's lovely. It's got this beautiful golden shade. Just splash some water to bring down the tawa temperature. And we've got 1 more ladle. Just go round. Smoothen it out, don't touch it after this, and just some oil, and let it do its job of crispening up. It might start to crack a bit and really dry up, so that's not a problem, just add a little more oil, it'll become even richer and even crispier. So I think we're good to go now. It's nice and brown from this edge, so let's turn it over and perfect! I'm really impressed with how it turned out, I hope you are too, so make sure you try it out and don't forget to tag me!